everyone, Janice Rosenberg here with RE/MAX United in Raleigh, North Carolina, and the Triangle. I wanted to introduce you today to Barbara Heathcote. She is the stager that I've used for quite a while now, and she is amazing at staging our homes. The name of her company is Home Staging to Sell. So, Barbara, let's talk about staging and what you do.
Sure.
So what's the difference between decorating and staging?
Oh, Janice, that is a great question. Decorating is really tailored for people who are living in their homes, who want a very specific look. They want to redo their house. They want to maybe put in some new furniture. When we stage, we tailor very specifically to the demographics of the buyer. And that is a very big difference right there. So we don't come in to decorate, we come in to stage to make sure there's an instant emotional connection with the home. And again, to make sure that we highlight the things that the home is showing, the fireplace, maybe there's tall ceilings, things like that. So we come in, and I call it a little bit of magic, because we come in to make sure that we can highlight those areas that the buyers are going to walk in and fall in love with right away.
Very good. So what are the benefits of staging a home?
Gosh, there are so many. First off, when people come in, they do fall in love very quickly with a house that's staged. And that's with every home that has been staged. And by the time they get to the upstairs, if there's an upstairs in the home, they've already fallen in love. And it also differentiates that home from others on the market. So that's a really big thing. The two biggest things are time on market. They go very, very quickly. Typically, our homes are gone within 1 to 2 days. I just heard from an agent, a peer of yours in Cary, who told me that a home we staged for her last week had 60 showings. Mm-hmm. And it went, had several offers, and went for over asking. And that's the other piece of this. Homes that are staged typically go for over asking, or at least asking price. So there is definitely a strong value in that.
Yes, I find that homes that show themselves very well on the photos and in person, the photos start things to get the buyers to want to come to the home. And so if there's a lot of clutter, it doesn't show well in the photos. And then when they walk in, they can't feel themselves living there. So that's why I find that buyers that walk into a home that's staged or presents itself extremely well is one that will get multiple offers and will get a lot more than asking or get super top dollar. So do you need to put your things in storage in order to make it present better?
You know, that's a very good question. I always tell people, declutter. Anything that you can do, picking up rugs, things like that, it adds a lot more visual space to the home. And anything that we can do to get that clutter out. The good thing is, if you have a garage, the garage is really something that you can put your things in. Buyers are very forgiving of things that are stacked in the garage. So you can always use that. Of course, if somebody feels that they need to move things to storage or a pod, I'm sure they could talk to you about that.
Mm-hmm. Yes, okay. So how will home staging impact the selling price? We did talk to that a little bit, and I have found that the homes that you have staged have absolutely won in the market. It doesn't necessarily mean that every single person has to stage their home. There are sellers out there that do a beautiful job of showcasing their own home, and in that case, we don't need a stager. They really get it and they know just what to do. I don't always have to see the house when it's ready to go on the market. I love to go and ask questions and see, what do you plan to do here? And then I can tell if they need help or not. So,
absolutely.
So what are you thinking? How do you know if you need a home stager or not?
Well, that's a really good question. I think if you feel very overwhelmed as a seller, maybe that's a good starting point to talk to you as their realtor. Maybe just for someone to come in and declutter. And that's where us as a home stager comes in. Certainly, a lot of people don't need a home stager, but some people feel either overwhelmed or they have so much in their home that they really need to cluttered, maybe furniture arrangement, etc. But I think it's a good starting point, but you bring up a very valid point that not everyone needs a home stager.
Well, great. So if I decide I want to stage a home, what's the best way to find a good stager?
Well, we are very lucky in Raleigh, in the Triangle. We have a lot of wonderful stagers here, and they all do very different things. Some do just occupied staging. Some do vacant. Some just do consults. We at Home Staging to Sell pretty much do everything, and we are available anytime someone calls for a quick discussion and consult. But again, we're very lucky that we have so many talented stagers here. But if anybody would like to reach out to me, they're welcome to.
Why don't you give your phone number?
Sure. It's Home Staging to Sell in Raleigh, North Carolina, 919-426-5089. And our website is www.homestagingtosellnow.com. And we welcome to take your home from for sale to sold.
Wonderful. And if anybody needs to reach me, I'm at 919-874-0124. And my cell is 919-815-0905. And our website is janicerosenberg.com. I hope this information is valuable to you all, and I'd love to hear from you. Bye-bye.